Happy Friday!
Before we get started, can we talk about how incredible last Friday's pep rally was? Going to a school that makes the best out of any situation makes us very proud. So thank you cheer, dance, band, and Ms. Holman for putting that on for us.
Anyway, welcome back, and here's episode 54.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Pointer Pack News Weather. I'm Brandon Miller. Hope everybody's having a good Friday out there today. The Pointers are heading to Choctaw, Oklahoma to take on the Yellow Jackets. Good luck to them. As we look at the temperatures for Friday, it's going to be mostly sunny with highs in the mid to upper 80s. As we look ahead to the weekend weather, it's going to be similar to Friday with sunny skies and temperatures in the mid 80s. And then as we look ahead to next week's weather, we're not going to have near as much rain as we saw last week, as temperatures will stay in the low to mid 80s. As we look at the world weather picture, Hurricane Nana hit Belize, registering barely as a hurricane with wind speeds of about 70 to 75 miles per hour. Now on to VBHS School News. Hope everybody has a great weekend.
Don't forget, junior class officer forms are due today. Elections will be held next Wednesday. For any sophomore or junior waiting to take the PSAT on October 17th, can sign up with Ms. Ivanelli in the Counseling Center. The cost is $17.
Students that ride the bus, please check your school email, fill out and submit the Google form.
If interested in joining CIA, please fill out and complete a membership form before October 1st. See Ms. Blakeney in T4 for any questions.
Stay tuned till the end of the video for a short video on what CIA has to offer.
This week's international news is, in Arizona, Judge Scott McCoy has removed Kanye West from the ballot on November 3rd in fear of confusion.
However, West will not be on the ballot for quite a few states. He will be able to run in Arkansas, Idaho, Iowa, Tennessee, and Utah.
This Tuesday, Vera Rivard, a 16-year-old from New Hampshire, swam across the English Channel. She completed a 33-mile swim, reaching France after dark. This feat took 14 hours to complete, and it was not her first, but she claims it will not be her last.
Saturday, September 12th, a lock of Abraham Lincoln's hair will be sold at an auction, along with a telegram about his 1865 assassination. The telegram will be up for sale at the Boston-based RR auction.
The auction has set the minimum at $10,000, but spokesman Mike Graff says the lock and telegram should sell over $75,000.
How's that for interesting things happening around the world? Now it's on to your local news.
For your Van Buren High School news, we want to congratulate this year's student senators.
Caleb Ferguson, Sonny Harrington, Carla Mesquita, and Lindy Michael, Brandon Miller, Gary Phillips, Elizabeth Rainwater, George Sandoval, and Pearl Sarath.
Juniors, Tyler Burns, Kara Chenoweth, Ethan Davis, Lydia Doolittle, Trevor Edelin, Lily Humphreys, Hayden Hurst, Beau Martin, and Isaac Nichols.
Sophomores, we've got Parker Brown, Maddie Cochran, Connellan Doss, Andrew Hammond, Levi Hubbs, Caitlin King, Ashton McKenna, Emily Fonavong, and Hallie Rackley.
And don't forget, any student who is driving needs to purchase a parking pass for $5 before September 25th.
And good luck for those taking the ACT tomorrow.
Here's your school shout-out for the week.
Our shout-out this week goes to both of our dog pound leaders, Caleb Ferguson and Andrew Wagner.
Even under strict circumstances, these two have led the student section in many chants to help the Pointers to victory. You can follow Caleb at caleb.ferguson24, and you can follow Andrew at andrew.wagner on Instagram.
Also, if you haven't seen them already, be sure to check out our interviews with them post-game last Friday night at Battle of the Bone.
Hey guys, I'm Tanner.
And I'm Sam, and this is Pointer Pack News Sports.
Last week was a great week for VBHS sports. Both the boys and the girls tennis improved their record to 4-1. Golf played two matches last week, winning against Northside Thursday.
This past week, our Pointers won 35-0 against the Airedales in the Battle of the Bone. Gary Phillips ran the first play for a touchdown, as Hayden Roark predicted in his interview with Tanner.
So in years past, we've all known the first play against Alma. Can you tell us what it is going to be this week?
I cannot tell you what it is, but I can guarantee you it's going to be big.
Can you give us a little hint?
It's a touchdown.
And his name is John C.
Yeah! Choctaw is giving the Pointers 400 tickets for the away game. If you're going, drive safe and be smart. Stay tuned till the end of the episode. We have a Battle of the Bones special. Check out the Pointer Pack News Instagram right here for interviews with staff, students, and players. I'm Sam.
And I'm Tanner. Get out your calendars because next week's sports is up with Kyle and Eli.
Hey, I'm Kyle.
And I'm Eli.
And we're here for your next week's sports coverage. Next week we have a break for football, and golf is at Russellville on Monday and Silent Springs on Wednesday. Tennis will play Monday against Silent Springs, Tuesday against Mountain Home, and Thursday against Russellville.
Volleyball will be at Mountain Home on Tuesday, and we'll play Alma on Thursday at home. Cross country runs in the Panther Classic at Siloam. And that's all for sports this week, folks.
Hey guys, today we'll be talking about school safety measures at VBHS. Okay guys, remember, the main stairwell is meant to go up while the hallway end stairwells are meant to go down. Remember, 3-2 table, no pulling up chairs. Come on guys. Okay guys, now someone's telling me that you're being a little bit mean to the teachers for them enforcing the distancing and mask wearing. Not cool guys.
For a random act of kindness this week, we're asking you to sincerely compliment someone's outfit.
Today marks the 19th anniversary of the 9/11. We are the generation not knowing different life before the 9/11. We would like to take a moment of silence to show our respect to those who lost their lives.
Reports that there was fire at the World Trade Center.
We understand that there has been a plane crash on the southern tip of Manhattan.
Has crashed into the World Trade Center in New York, 852.
Lots of thick black smoke coming from the top of the World Trade Center. It looks like the plane struck about three-quarters of the way up, maybe a little higher.
Yeah, I can't, it's unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this in my life.
Oh my God.
I realized that we were attacked on our home, and that it never happened. All of us were packed and we were trying to get home and just figure out, dang, how are we gonna recover from this?
I think the freakiest thing ever was that whole week or two was every time you'd leave your house, you'd look up and there were no planes.
The captain of the ship bowed to the Marine commander. He went up there and gave a speech that I will never forget for the rest of my life. And he goes, "Gentlemen and ladies, December 7th, 1941 was the day of infamy for my father and for all your grandfathers. Today, the world will know that September 11th, 2001 is your day of infamy."
That's it for episode 54, guys. We do have a few student submissions this week. Be sure to send more at our Instagram at VBHS Pointer Pack News.
Consciousness.
all showed a lot of heart against the Evil Tuesday.
Hey, everybody.
Yeah, I just forgot the date.
Check out the Pointer Pack News Instagram. You didn't do it.
Strawberry stem.
Bam! 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 We're supposed to be touching. No, probably not. Yeah, I can do it with you even.
Whatever. Okay, I think that's good.
Cultures in Action Club, or CIA, provides opportunities to explore and educate others about world languages and cultures through a variety of activities. Sponsors are the world language teachers. CIA is a very active club with guest speakers from other countries, world movie nights, and socials with food, games, and crafts. Also, field trips such as Oktoberfest at ATU, and Spanish language concerts. CIA leads the VBHS Fall Festival, cleans the cemetery for Day of the Dead, has a K-pop crew that performs in the talent show, presents multicultural story times at the public library, hosts an activity room at the State World Language Competition, provides a multicultural festival called Pointer Palooza to the community, has an international buddy program and newcomer mentor program, informs about local opportunities to experience multiculturalism and learn other languages, such as ASL or Chinese, and more. If interested in being a part of this amazing club, don't miss the deadline to join.